right, what's going on, man? I'm back at it. Look, you know, there's a situation that I wanted to kind of talk about. You probably heard about it. You probably saw it where there was a situation down in Mississippi at a Walmart where a woman, a mother, she had her child outside and only a diaper. And this happened, I think, a couple weeks ago at a time when we had some real, you know, frigid temperatures sweeping across the country. So it was cold. I think I read something where it was like down in the 20s out that way. And this baby only had a diaper on inside the Walmart. So I'm going to show you this just in case you haven't had a chance to see it. And then I'm going to come back and just give you my thoughts. Because me and my wife, we were talking about this. But there are two things which I think are important to talk about in this situation. So let me go ahead and let y'all check this one out.
A viral video on social media shows a Byram mother shopping in Walmart with her two-year-old son, who was unclothed, only wearing a diaper. That woman is behind bars tonight. Byram police charged Cambria Darby with child neglect. The Walmart employee who recorded the video has since been fired. 300 Size Chris Field spoke exclusively with the former employee.
That's right, Ashley. Felicia Darling says she recorded the incident January 17th. She claims she was fired because she went against company policy for posting the video on social media. Darling spoke exclusively to Three on Your Side about what she saw on that cold winter day.
What she did was unacceptable, and like, she should be accounted for her actions.
Felicia Darling is still trying to wrap her head around this disturbing video she recorded of a two-year-old. Here you can see the toddler shaking and shivering as people walked up, concerned about the extremely cold weather that night. She placed the boy in a cart basket, only wearing a diaper, and that's when she started recording.
You know, she was being like very rude and all that, so.
Lower your voice.
Darling says after several shoppers approached the mom in the store, that's when she took off her black coat and put it on the baby.
If you're a mother, a child represents you. And if you come in the store fully clothed and your son's not, you know, that shows a lot about your character. And that shows a lot that you don't care. And like, how could you come in Walmart fully dressed and, you know, it's a lot of people watching you. She probably thought nobody was going to say anything or step up, but you know, we did.
Child Protection Services also got involved and later released the child to an approved relative.
I wasn't thinking about the consequences or of my actions. You know, at that time, I wanted to get that baby help.
After being fired, Darling received an overwhelming amount of support. A GoFundMe that was recently set up has already raised more than $25,000 just for Darling.
I thank everyone that has donated. You know, it's like overwhelming. I didn't know I was gonna get this much support.
Now, Darby was processed and booked at the Hinds County Detention Center on bond conditions ordered by the Hinds County Youth Court. I'm Chris Field.
All right, man. So, yeah, I've always said that there's no manual when it comes to parenting. And some things you get right, some things you get wrong. But some things should just be plain old common sense. Nobody's saying that you got to go out here and be a perfect parent. But when it comes to something as simple as dressing your children appropriately for the weather, I mean, it should be a no-brainer. Just like you got to feed them, just like you got to house them. These are the things that shouldn't take long to think about. And then to add to those things is that you're the parent. So you're responsible for the safety of that child, because they can't take care of themselves, because they have to rely on you as the parent. But as you saw in that video, this mother, she was dressed for the weather. So what I'm trying to figure out is how did she think that it would be okay to bring that child out of the house with just a diaper on, out there in those temperatures? Plus, I mean, those stores can be cold even when it's hot outside. especially over in the refrigerated and frozen sections. I know with my kids, a lot of times when we go out, even if it's hot outside, you know, I throw a jacket or something in the car because we may have to stop at the grocery store to pick up something, or, you know, some small items or something like that. And I know it gets cold because sometimes I get cold in the stores too. But the mother, she eventually put her own jacket on the baby. And that was only after other witnesses and the Walmart employee, they spoke up about the baby shivering in the cart. But my thing is, why even bring a child out of the house like that in the first place with only a diaper on? She wouldn't have had to take her own jacket off if that child had been dressed for the weather to begin with. And then she goes on to get an attitude with the people after they started checking her and calling her out for it, because I think she knew better than that. And I think it was maybe a thing of where she's done something like this before and nobody said anything up until now, because a lot of people, they're not going to get involved. But the mother of the child, she was arrested and CPS got involved and the child was released to a relative. And the mother is currently, I guess, waiting for a court date. Now, the next thing is that the Walmart employee, Felicia, she was fired. She was the one who recorded the video. And a lot of people are saying that she shouldn't have been fired over the video. But the video was posted to her Facebook page. And what I read when the GoFundMe, I think she had a GoFundMe page up. I went and looked at it. She was saying that she did post the video to Facebook in order to reach out to some of her family members and caseworkers. And then her manager contacted her after the video went viral and she was told to take it down, which she did. But when she went back to work after 2 days off, she was fired 2 hours before her shift ended for violating company policy. Personally, you know, I don't think that she should have been fired, but you got to understand that when it comes to these companies or just when you're working for people, you got to understand that you can be fired for what you post on social media. It's happened before. And then you got to understand what at-will employment means. And that means, because I think down there, down there in Mississippi, which is, it's an at-will state, meaning that a person can be fired for any reason as long as it's not discriminatory. So I think that's the position that Walmart was kind of taking on that. And I think they were kind of looking at it like, well, she was on company time, even though she stepped up and did the right thing when a lot of people wouldn't have. But I think because that video got posted to social media, that may have put her in direct violation of said company policy. Because I know a lot of places, they do have policies where employees can't record and post to social media while on company property and company time. I think things would have been different had she simply recorded the video for evidence to be provided to law enforcement or CPS just to kind of assist them in their investigation. But I believe the major issue came in was that video, it hit social media. And she did say that she took it down when her manager asked, but when it comes to putting stuff out on the internet and online, once it's out there, it's out there. You can't take that stuff down. I mean, you could try to take it down and you can delete it, but who's to say it wasn't copied and shared elsewhere in the amount of time that it was up? So you got to be careful with those things. But anyway, you know, I was just thinking about something else too. Maybe this was Walmart's way of just getting rid of her. Maybe they already had plans to get rid of her, and this was just, you know, the right situation or the right time for them to go ahead and do it. But you know, life happens, and I think she'll be fine. She did have a GoFundMe page up, and like in that report, people donated more than $25,000. So I think that'll probably help her out. So she can transition into something better, and hopefully she finds something better. But as for the mother of that shivering child in that grocery cart, hopefully she too can get things together and just try her best to move forward and make better decisions next time. It may take a minute for things to cool down a bit, because I mean, this video, it went viral. It's all over at this point. So, you know, the humiliation and embarrassment is going to be there. It's going to sting for a minute. But I think she'll end up being okay too. But yeah, just slow down. Think about what it is that you about to do and ask yourself, does it make sense? And if it doesn't, man, you might want to kind of go back to the drawing board before you make that decision. So just a little something to think about. And I'll see you on the next one. Take care. Stay safe. Peace, y'all.